You know what, Miss Delaby Antoine, you really are a country girl. You know that?
Yes.
Yeah.
How'd you know?
I could tell by the way you ordered it. Let me get molasses with my cornbread.
Were you raised on a farm?
My mother did a little sharecropping in Florida.
She's still there?
God bless her heart. She passed away when I went to school.
Ray, I'm sorry.
She never was real healthy. She just worked herself to death, poor thing. That's why she didn't want me carrying around no tin cup. I mean, the kids I went to school with, they were doing basket weaving and wicker work.
But not you, because of your gift.
Because of my ears. See, I can mimic damn near anybody, and I make a pretty decent living at it. It's just if I change my style up and people really don't dig it, I mean, what am I left with, you know? I mean, when you're blind, Miss Antoine, you ain't got that many choices.
Seemed to me like you got all the choices in the world. God gave you the gift to sound like anybody you please, even yourself. We're here. This is where I live.
Could you think the preacher let me in? I mean, I'm a sinner, but I need a little prayer.
His wife don't likely have a male company.
But tell him there's a soul out here that needs saving. You know what, Miss Antoine, you really got me thinking.
About what?
About my life. About my music. About everything.
Ray, don't you think we're moving a little fast?
Listen, I'm gonna go to New York for a couple of weeks, and when I get back, you can take it as slow as you want.
All right, Mr. Charles.
All right, Miss Antoine. I'll see you in a couple of weeks.
Well, hold on now. Let me call you a cab.
I got it. 3 blocks up, left for 2, right for 1, 15 Dodge steps, and I'm at the Crystal White Hotel. Hello.